One of the most common laboratory tests ordered by doctors is the complete blood count, also known as a CBC. In this video, I will be explaining this test and I'll show you some examples of abnormal results. Enjoy the video. Before we dive in, there's a couple of things I'd like to mention. Number one, for the complete blood count test, you don't have to fast. You can just show up to the lab. You can have a full stomach. You don't have to be fasting for it. Number two, this test tests your white blood cells and red blood cells and platelets. So in a normal situation, whenever you bleed out or when you have your blood drawn, your blood will clot. So the lab will collect your blood in a special tube. It's the lavender top tube seen here. And this has a chemical in it which prevents your blood from clotting. And the reason why I'm mentioning this is because sometimes whenever the lab draws your blood, there may be an error with it and some of the blood will clot in the tube when it's not supposed to. And that could throw off the results. And the main thing that you'll see there is you may see a false low platelet count because all of your platelets are all clumped up somewhere in the tube when really inside of the tube it should all be liquid, not clotted. Here's an example of a normal test result, and you can see that they test several different things on here. We'll go through each one of them right now. The first thing on the list is WBC, which stands for white blood cells. And this is just counting the number of white blood cells that are present in the sample. Next is the RBC, or the red blood cells. And this is just like the white blood cells, we're counting the number of red blood cells that are present in the sample. Next is the amount of hemoglobin in the sample. And hemoglobin is a protein that is in your red blood cells that helps you to carry oxygen around. So individuals who have a low hemoglobin will have less oxygen carried around and they will be anemic. The hematocrit measured as a percentage here tells you what percentage of the sample is made up of cells versus made up of the liquid part of the blood. So if there's a low percentage, if your hematocrit is low, that indicates that you don't have enough red blood cells, mainly red blood cells, in the sample, and that would indicate that you have anemia as well. MCV stands for mean corpuscular volume, which basically means the average size of your red blood cells. So if this number is large, it indicates that your red blood cells are larger than normal. And if it's small, it indicates that your red blood cells are smaller than normal. And the significance of this we'll get into whenever we look at some of the abnormal lab results. Next, I'm gonna lump these two together. This is the MCH and the MCHC. This stands for mean corpuscular hemoglobin, or average amount of hemoglobin per red blood cell. And this one is mean corpuscular hemoglobin concentration. This is the overall concentration of hemoglobin that is seen in the sample. So if both of these are low too, again, this would be an indication of anemia. And usually if the average hemoglobin is low, we're gonna see a low hemoglobin as well. Next is the RDW, which stands for red cell distribution width. And you can see this one is also a percentage. What this tells you is the variability in the sizes of your red blood cells in the sample. So some folks will have varying degrees. They'll have smaller cells and larger cells. If there's a huge difference in the size of cells, this RDW will be elevated, and that will tell us that'll tell us some potential causes of the anemia. So if the sizes are way different, then we would assume that maybe this patient has recently lost some blood. And if we see that the red blood cell count is low, hemoglobin is low, and hematocrit is low, and then we have a large RDW, red cell distribution width, then we know that their anemia is likely caused from recent blood loss, or maybe there's some hidden blood loss that we don't know about and we have to kind of look and see where the blood loss is coming from. In many cases, hidden blood loss could be lost in the stool. For women who are having menstrual cycles, that's the main area where they're losing blood. Next is the platelet count. Platelets are things in your blood that helps your blood to clot. So if you have an injury, your body needs to patch it up, and it does that with the help of platelets and some other clotting factors. And this lab counts the number of platelets. So for someone who has low platelets, if it's severely low, then we worry that they may get an injury, a cut or something, and they may be bleeding, and they could essentially bleed out. Somebody who has low platelets, and if they have an internal injury, they could bleed out and die, and you wouldn't even know because you can't see the blood because it's an internal injury. So knowing what the platelet count is very, very important. The next section right here, starting with the neutrophils and then down to the immature granulocytes, is showing you what portion of the white blood cells, see we did the white blood cell count, what portion of that consists of various types of white blood cells. So we have neutrophils, lymphocytes, monocytes, eosinophils, and basophils. And then you can see that it looks like it repeats it down here below it. So up here we're talking about the percentage. So what percentage of the white blood cells are neutrophils? What percentage are the lymphocytes? Down here, which I like these better, these are the absolute values. These tell you how many they count. They actually count the number of neutrophils. They count the number of lymphocytes. So we have two different things to show us. And you can see right here, this is called a CBC with differential and platelets. This is what I usually order. There's also just a basic CBC, but for the purpose of this video, I'll be going over the CBC with the differential. And the differential shows you the absolute values down here, which I prefer to see on my patients. So if we have any of these are elevated, they'll indicate specific things. I'll talk about those in a minute whenever I go over some of the abnormal lab results. I just want to talk about these immature granulocytes down here at the bottom. If these are elevated, it's just another indication that the body is making new white blood cells. So if someone has an infection or they're having inflammation, or even if they're having some types of blood cancers, these immature granulocytes may be elevated. Now, if it's a blood cancer, we'll generally see the immature granulocytes being more elevated. But if it's just mildly elevated, and I'll show you an example in a minute, then it indicates that the person is having an infection or some type of inflammatory process. Let's take a look at some abnormal test results. So on this CBC, we can see that the red blood cells were high. So this person has high red blood cells, but their hemoglobin is low, which is kind of weird because you would think that the hemoglobin would be lower if the red blood cell count is lower. Let's look further. We have a low MCV, a low red size of your red blood cells. So this person has smaller red blood cells. The MCH, mean corpuscular hemoglobin, the average amount of hemoglobin in the red blood cells is low. The average concentration of hemoglobin is low. And the RDW, remember what I told you earlier, the RDW is high. So there's a large variability in the sizes of their red blood cells. And so since this person has high red blood cells, what this looks like is, it looks like their body is now, we took the sample at a time when their body is compensating for a recent blood loss. The red cell distribution width is high, so we know that their body is actively trying to make new red blood cells to replace the old ones, and in this case, it looks like they overshot it. Their body started making like too many red blood cells, and that's why that's a little elevated. Now there's some other reasons why this could be elevated, but for this sample right here, this is what it looks like. It looks like that's the reason why the red blood cells are elevated and we have anemia. Whenever you're analyzing these tests, or when your doctor is analyzing the tests, they don't just go by the test. There's other things you know about the patient's case that clues you in. And I know this patient's case, so I know that this is, in this patient's case, they were having blood loss from having heavy menstrual bleeding. So you can't just rely, like if your doctor gives you your lab results and then you watch this video and you see, oh man, you know, I might have this, I might have that. You need to have your doctor's guidance too, because the doctor doing the intake, they'll get more information from talking to you, and then they'll correlate that with your lab results to give you your diagnosis. So I know in this case, it's anemia from blood loss, and it's the patient's body was compensating by making more red blood cells. Here's an example of high platelets. So this patient's platelets are 682, which you can see is well above the range. This isn't extremely high, but it's a little bit high. And what this indicates usually is that this patient has some kind of inflammation going on in their body. So for most cases, when platelets are around this level of elevation, we could assume that there's some inflammation going on in the body. And if we scroll, look down here lower, we could see that lymphocytes and monocytes were elevated. These are two different types of white blood cells. And so this patient is likely fighting an infection, which would increase their inflammation, which would increase the platelets. Here's one where there's a couple things going on. We can see red blood cell count was low and the hemoglobin was low. So they have some type of anemia going on, some type of anemia from blood loss. All these other indices on the red blood cells were normal, but you can see down here their neutrophils were, their absolute neutrophils were elevated, and the monocytes were elevated, which would indicate an infection. So there's a couple things going on. They have anemia, and there's some type of inflammatory process or an infection going on in their body. Here's the last example, and in this case, it's a little bit more extreme. We can see that this patient's white blood cell count was pretty high, 19.2, and their lymphocytes, their absolute lymphocytes, was 13.4, which is very high, and I was a little uncomfortable with this high of lymphocytes, and we could see the immature granulocytes, the absolute, so the actual counting of the immature granulocytes, and this one was elevated here too. So either this patient, and I know that they were sick when they had this done, so I know they had an infection, but I'm uncomfortable seeing the absolute lymphocytes this high. This would be something where we would retest the CBC in a couple of weeks when the patient's feeling better, just to see if it goes back down. And if it remains elevated or the lymphocytes are getting even higher, then we may refer out to a hematologist, so the patient, or an oncologist, to make sure that the patient doesn't have any type of blood cancer. And oftentimes whenever a patient does have a type of blood cancer, all of these things will be off, you know, the red, because your bone marrow makes the red blood cells and white blood cells. And so if you have some cancer cells, a line of cancer cells making lymphocytes in there, then all resources are gonna be used up, and you're gonna see like anemia, you're gonna see low red blood cell count. All the other types of cells lines will be lower, but the one that is the cancerous one, the lymphocyte in this case, will be higher. And that's it for the complete blood count. If you have any questions, feel free to leave those down in the comments section below. I love going over labs, and here's something that I want to start doing is have viewers like you submit your laboratory reports, and I could maybe make a YouTube video on that. Of course, I follow all HIPAA. I don't show your information. More details down below in the description section of the video if you'd like me to go over any of your labs. And I'm free to go over any type of labs you've done. I mean, if you've done, had food sensitivity tests done and you want to see it on a YouTube video, or if you've had like a stool test or hormonal testing done and you want to see it on one of my videos, then go ahead and fill out the form and submit it, and I may choose yours and do a video on it. If you like the video, consider giving it a thumbs up, and if you haven't already, please hit the subscribe button and click the bell so that you don't miss out on future videos. I thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.